Morning to you all. Welcome to the Rethink India National Convention of Futuristic Schools of India 2017. किसी भी कार्य की मांगलिक शुरुआत के लिए आवश्यक है कि हम दीप प्रज्वलन से प्रारंभ करें. So I would like to invite the Honorable Chairperson of Rethink India Foundation, Shri R.K. Vaish, to please invite the other dignitaries present out here. I would request sir to please initiate the process. I will request Pavan Gupta ji, who has come down specially for the special talk out here, giving the inaugural address, to please come on the stage. I would request Sri Balbir Tikta sir to please come on the stage to participate in the lighting of the lamp. I would request Professor Zahoor Ahmed Chhat, who is the Honorable Chairperson of Jammu Kashmir State Board of Education, to please join us for the lighting of the lamp ceremony. I would also request Mr. Arjun Bahadur from the British Council to please join us in this inaugural ceremony. And I will also request our ever charming friend and friend philosopher and guide for this wonderful congregation, Mr. Aurobindo Saxena, who is the head educational practice at Technopack Advisors, to please also join us. Sir, to please be seated on the stage for this inaugural ceremony, and Professor Chhat also to please be seated out here. Pavan sir, this is your session, so please be seated on the dais. I will now request Sri R.K. Vaish sir to give away the welcome address.
As Chairperson of Rethink India Foundation, it's my great honor and privilege to welcome you all today to this National Convention of Futuristic Schools of India. Being a nationalist think tank, leveraging the power and means of a business and specialty media platform, it has been the constant endeavor of Rethink India ever since its Uttu watch and engineering watch days dating back to the year 2009 to nurture credible communities of practice in the domain of education. Academia, which we at Rethink India consider as the fifth and the foremost estate, catalyzing and sustaining the virility and vitality of our national being, remains the key focal point of our all-round discourse. Just 60 days back, the Honorable Prime Minister of India exhorted the countrymen to awake, arise, and endeavor to the creation of the new India. A new India, which encompasses the motives and meanings of modernized national life, in due consonance with the aspirations of this youthful nation of 125 crore people. In the Rethink India thought universe, the realization of this lofty ideal would require the proactive participation of India's vast academic establishment. It shall need due thinking, which we qualify as out of the box and out of the brief. As we march forward in our journey, we are somewhere being bogged down by a ceaseless spree of systems and processes, protocols and prescriptions, which at times do hamper the foundations of original creative thinking, out of the box, out of the brief. We are too overawed by these externalities that the intrinsic development takes a backseat. Having served the Indian Administrative Service for a little less than 4 decades, serving the strategic and developmental interest of the northeastern state of Tripura, I find myself empowered and experienced enough to state that the germination of newer creative thoughts and their due internalization into the national body can only be accentuated in the cauldron of academia, which has been entrusted with the onerous responsibility of undertaking open cerebral surgery. It's only in the creative but secure confines of academic institutions does the character of a nation gets forged in. It's only at the hands of sculptors like you, the academicians, does the nation's future gets chiseled and crafted in due consonance with its collective aspirations. Whether it is a dream of a Swachh Bharat or that of a digital India, the academia has to take charge to make it happen in letter and spirit. The government of the day, run by a bureaucracy, directed by the legislature, monitored by the judiciary, and commented upon by the media, can only provide the outer framework of public delivery systems duly supported by industry establishments. The internal mechanizations shall, however, remain in the sacred confines of academia and academia alone. Nonetheless, of late, there has been a marked observation that the academia is getting bereft of its lead role in the Indian society owing to a number of internal as well as external forces. It's happening both at the level of identity as well as that of the role. This convention is probably a humble attempt in this direction to resuscitate both the identity and as well as the role of academia in the larger national narrative. We all know about Lord Hanuman, the lead character of Ramayana. He forgets his own potential, which is reinstated by Jamvant on the occasion of initiating a transoceanic expedition to find the whereabouts of Sita. India's academia is like Hanuman, which happens to be the most vital stakeholder for the creation of a new India and needs to be reminded of its innate intrinsic potential, which shall then get manifested in vivid eclectic forms of incessant creativity. The Sita of New India can only be excavated when the Hanuman is duly reminded of his intrinsic identity and role. This National Convention of Futuristic Schools of India has been convened with this very specific purpose, with the hordes of Jamvans from various walks of life. We have got an eminent educationist in Sri Pavan Gupta ji, who has devoted his entire lifetime to his experiments in education in the hills of Missouri. An IITian of the 1968 batch of IIT Delhi, Pavanji is the founder of Society of Integrated Development of Himalayas. His seminal work titled A Matter of Quality has found impelling reverberations in the annals of United Nations as well. Education of relevance is a theme which he champions fervently. You shall therefore find him proposing his view in native Hindi, leveraging the indigenous cultural motifs which are so very central for effective comprehension. Pavanji, as he is affectionately addressed across the quarters, would thereby invoke this forum with his meanderings into the philosophical foundations of education. I take this opportunity to welcome Pavanji, a modern servant, by all means, to this house. We have with us Mr. Arvindo Saxena, the head of educational practice at Technopac Advisors. Mr. Saxena is a man of profound wisdom who pursues the next and best trends in education globally with a razor sharp focus. The diversity of educational narrative captured by him remains a most sought after proposition. We at Rethink India are grateful to him and his organization, Technopac Advisors, to have supported us as a knowledge partner in the curation of this eclectic convention. He shall be presenting an overview of the Indian school educational landscape. We welcome Mr. Saxena. Today we are fortunate enough to receive a first-hand sneak peek into the globally acclaimed educational ecosystems in South Korea and United Kingdom. We would have with us Dr. Lee, Professor, Center for Korean Studies. And Sri Arjun Bahadur, Assistant Director, Schools, Education Society, British Council Division, British High Commission, to illuminate us on this frontier. In the Rig Vedic spirit, let noble thoughts come to us from all directions. I hope this interaction shall help us immensely in discovering the identity and role which advanced nations accord to their educational institutions. In South Korea, jets are grounded when their next generation takes their public examination. Such is their non-compromising focus and dedication to the pursuit of education. India's rise on the global forefront is largely to its English education system established during the British rule. We need to learn from the latest advances which the British have made to the New Age Renaissance, which their New Age barons are leading the world into. London, the imperial city of the world, still continues its charm as the learning capital of the world. By all means, this house welcome Mr. Bahadur. We are deeply honored by your august presence and thank you. Thank your respective embassies for having empowered this congregation by deputing you to grace the proceedings out here. The pursuit of happiness has become the single most national priority for the United Arab Emirates. Dubai, which has emerged to be a global city, has shown to the world as to what's not possible out of a grand vision and relentless industriousness, a value which is imperative for the creation of a new India and of which our Prime Minister is a glaring living example. Snehal Sunil Adeka, and Gaurav Dhal of Dubai Scouts Mission, UAE, shall be mesmerizing us as to how the global edu destination of Dubai, with almost all the top brands in education, edutains itself by way of scouting and extracurricular rendezvous, which instills the qualities of leadership, strategic thinking, and most importantly, daring, which somehow is getting compromised in an ever-increasing ecosystem of pacifism, which scholars ascribe to the Arjun syndrome. We welcome them both. This is also to express our thanks to Dubai Scouts Mission for extending the courtesy of hosting the National Technology Day lunch for all of us. I hope that the intoxicating pursuit of national happiness of Dubai does flow to the Indian shores across the Arabian Sea by leaps and bounds. Mr. Vasant Agrawal is an author and consultant on mental health, de-addiction and counseling. After having pursued a lifetime engineering career in the land of Uncle Sam, he found his inner calling of giving back and returned back to establish the four life positive mission. Though he uses this symptomatic approach of the West in the Freudian worldview, his work has a great relevance in concurrent times when increased aspirations and heightened stress levels are buckling down the youngsters quite early in their life, even before blossoming. The stress is not just on the shoulders, it's deeply impregnated into the head as well as the heart, where the addiction to the fear of failure, living in comparisons, have become the dominant social norm away from the doctrine of karma, which empowers and elevates. His use of the term addiction is characteristic and noteworthy. Negative motives at times do draw our attention faster than the positive ones. We welcome you, Mr. Agrawal, to this August congregation. Rethink India has always believed in the beauty of a bottom-up approach, a welfare state which intends to nurture its 6 lakh plus hamlets has to follow the organic bottoms-up pedigree. From cells to tissues, from tissues to organs, from organs to organ systems, and then to the whole body, India's beautiful tree of education, a term I borrow from Gandhiji's assertion during the second roundtable conference in London, comprised of a vast network of schools. As per surveys done by a British officer in Bengal, the presidency boasted of over 1 lakh schools of its own pedigree, and Pavanji would surely love to touch upon this in his address. It's a count which we have as of today when it comes to grade 12 schools. The Rethink India National Convention of Futuristic Schools of India is honored to have the chairpersons and senior officials of various state boards of the country. I would like to welcome Professor Zahoor Chatt, chairperson, Jammu Kashmir State Board of School Education. We would be having, hopefully, Dr. Ashok, Sardar Balveer Singh Dhol, Mr. Mahamane, I think they are a little late, they'll be joining us. I welcome Mr. Balveer Tekta, Chairperson, Himachal Pradesh Board of School Education, and other senior representatives from the Madhya Pradesh Board of Secondary Education. We will be having also representatives shortly from Meghalaya Board and Assam Higher Secondary Educational Council. To our extreme delight, the state school boards are faring equally well when it comes to a futuristic drive in education. Rethink India expert team conducted an analysis on a host of parameters in the online space to evaluate empirically the performance of the official web portals of the various school boards of the country, which can be, to a fair degree of reason, can be considered to bear a direct correlation to the technological friendliness. Based on this elaborate analysis, a ranking of the futuristic school boards of India has been curated. We are honored and privileged enough that the honorable school boards have found reason and meaning in this and have accepted our humble invite to felicitate them for this progressive drive of theirs, as reflected from the quality of performance of their official web portal. We shall unravel more about the great work going on in states when it comes to the empowerment and enunciation of education, as against the much tom-tom ease of doing business in state. For us at Rethink India, education is a fountainhead of all economic pursuits and thereby should be accorded an equal, if not more importance than care. If economic pursuits cater to the jada prakriti, education is all about Chetan Purush, the classic yin and yang of the Indian pantheon. I would like to welcome Mr. Sanjay Majumdar, Associate Director of the Oxford University Press. He shall be talking to us on the possibility of combining digital with print books. Are integrated technologies the future of education in India? OUP, being a doyen of knowledge, is quite well suited to propose and envision the future of the means of learning and training. Technology has become the fulcrum of facilitating all futuristic pursuits across the spectrum, including education. While the conventional pedagogies and practices do retain their value, smart synthesis with the emerging frontiers of educational technology have demonstrated mesmerizing outcomes. However, the catch does lie in the adoption strategy and approach. We have with us a host of edutech leaders from the top-notch edutech companies. It's the honor and privilege of Rethink India Foundation to felicitate some of the leading lights in this space with the EduTech Leader of India Award this evening. I would like to welcome Sri Ralhan, Chief Executive Officer, Nest Education, Sri Khemka, Sri Reddy, Co-Founder, Kreya Learning, Sri Ashutosh Khurana, CEO of Chota Lab, and Sri Raj Mrityunjayappa, Managing Director of Talisma Corporation Private Limited, for having accepted the proposal to accept this honor from this committed forum. I would also like to welcome the representatives of Renew Power to this congregation. And I also welcome the entire community of futuristic schools who have assembled here from the nook and cranny of the country. They undertook an extensive effort to fill in their nomination papers, which are duly scrutinized by the editorial board of Rethink India. It does need the backing of a substantial commitment to fill a 10-pager nomination form asking for a host of abstract information. The National Convention is not a single day wonder. This convention is the start of a grand beginning of an year-long engagement whereby the community of futuristic schools of India shall take the lead in catalyzing the imperative of this convention to catapult an out-of-the-box and out-of-the-brief thinking. We shall be proposing as to how this shall be done during the course of the day. I welcome one and all for having made to this occasion, which in the acronym FREAK world happens to be the 5/11 of India. It was on this day, way back in 1999, Prime Minister Sri Atal Bihari Vajpayee Ji had chosen to announce the arrival of a modern India, which was capable and assertive enough to march on and assertive enough to march on, leveraging the firm foundations of her civilizational wisdom and soaring height with the aspirations and commitment of her billion plus population. It is on this day we take the pledge for a new India, duly catapulted by the academia of this nation, which has been known to be the Jagat Guru since times immemorial. Rethink India has also instituted the Bharat Ratna Atal Bihari Vajpayee Awards for innovation to mark this very day. And the very poet Ravel, whose prophetic words you can witness in this August house at India International Center. I thank you all for this patient hearing and invite you to be a proactive participant of this day-long Gyan Yagna. This is a forum whereby we all are seekers, seeker on stage and off stage, devoid of any protocol of prescription, in the true spirit of academic freedom and iconoclasm. Let's ask questions. Let's put forth our perspectives. Let's enunciate our concerns. Let's celebrate all possibilities. Let the Rethink India National Convention of Futuristic Schools of India 2017 on this 11th day of May 2017 begin. Thank you.